With me in the studio this afternoon from Eco Atlantic Oil and Gas, I've got Gil Holzman. Gil, good to see you again.
Good afternoon, Andrew. Good to see you again.
Big night last night. Yeah, that transfer of the 25% interest in Orinduik, that's been given the official okay now by the authorities in Guyana.
From the president himself. He's the minister in charge of petroleum affairs as well. But that's just another brick in the wall. We started to explore the block back in 2016 together with Tullow. And with every well that ExxonMobil on the adjacent block put in and came up with a success, the block became more and more prospective and less risky, up to the point where Total have actually acquired an option from us to take a look at the 3D that we shot back in September 2017. And to decide whether they want to acquire 25% of our 40% in return for a nice amount of cash. A day after the Hammerhead discovery back in September this year, Total exercised their option, and yesterday's approval by the president himself of Guyana for Total to come in and partner with us on the block, as I said, marked yet another milestone, small but very important for us, towards next year drilling campaign. So now we have Tullow with 60% as operator, Total, another small company, with 25%, and ourselves, Eco Atlantic, with 15%, about to drill a block which could potentially hold 3 billion barrels of oil.
Well, tell me a bit more about those plans. How many wells are we talking next year?
Minimum of one, but I think that with the recent discovery made on the Hammerhead prospect by Exxon, just 2 months ago, that, how would I put it, that looks to extend into our block. It's only 4.5 kilometers down deep from our field, or from our block. And it looks, based on the 3D that we have, it looks like it extends into our block. The plan is to, naturally, to test this one, and to get together now with Total as an official partner on the block, and with Tullow as operator, we will get together in the next couple of weeks in order to try and agree drilling targets, drilling plan, and drilling budget, all coming into 2018, so starting, you know, probably a few months from now. So the plan is to drill a minimum of one well, but by what I hear from our technical team with Colin Kinley, and by what I hear from Tullow and Total technical teams, they're really bullish about it, and we will try and probably test additional prospects on the block, but we'll see. Time will tell.
Exactly. Well, it still needs to be nailed down. But what, in your view, what's the most realistic outcome? How many could you be testing?
Listen, we are funded for at least four wells at current rig rates in the area. As I said, Total will transfer now at $12.5 million in cash. That will add up. That will double our cash position or cash balance. So we're going to end up with $24 million worth of cash as of next few weeks. At current rig rates offshore Guyana, this will be sufficient for at least four wells, I think. So my personal belief is that the discovery will come after the first one or two wells, so we'll see. But definitely 2018 will be extremely interesting and hopefully transformational for us.
How soon next year could you be drilling, do you think?
Current plan is Q3. However, as I said, we still need to meet together as the operations committee. We will meet with Tullow and Total. We are drill ready. We identified some of the targets. We applied for environmental clearance. I think it's mainly about approving the budget and sourcing for a rig. So, current plan is Q3 2018. I wouldn't be surprised if we could push that a bit early.
So you've applied for the environmental clearance?
Yes. Again, Tullow is the operator and they're doing a great job down there in Guyana. They're in touch with all the relevant authorities. We're progressing the block on a very fast track kind of basis. To remind you, we were only awarded with the block in January 2016.
That's right.
Now we are at towards the end of 2018 and we're about to drill it next year. It's 3.5 years ahead of time. So
you're pretty excited.
I am excited. It's a company maker.
And so Guyana, I mean, this is really the main focus now for EcoAtlantic, right?
Not for EcoAtlantic, not only for EcoAtlantic. It's the main focus for ExxonMobil. Mm. It's the main focus for Tullow. It's the main focus for Total now. Total have recently farmed into three blocks. One, we were the first one, but they farmed into two additional blocks over there. All the super majors, all the majors, all the big independents are, you know, eyeing acreage in Guyana. And it's not a surprise. ExxonMobil drilled 13 wells with 12 hits. That's a nice hit rate at 92%. And they already booked more than 4 billion barrels of recoverable oil. They're going to start produce oil next year with the first FPSO on Liza field. But the bigger plan is to operate five FPSOs by 2025 by Exxon and to drill almost one and to pump almost 1 million barrels a day. Hmm. This is big. This is massive. This is the real elephant hunt that Echo was all about to start with.
Are you... I mean, you say it's a potential game changer. You're happy with that 15% then?
More than happy. This is exactly the size of what we... Our strategy is to come in early into prospective oil basins in stable jurisdictions, and we take a very large stake of working interest to start with, 100%, 90%, 80%. But the thinking is always to farm down and to bring in bigger partners to help us also from the technical aspect, bringing a lot of technical horsepower, but also from the financial aspect. We feel very comfortable to end up on each block with 15 to 25% working interest upon the big discovery. Hmm. I hope that this is what will happen next year in Guyana. Having in mind that we reported more than 3 billion barrels, or around 3 billion barrels of prospective potential resource on a P50 basis, best estimate, you do the math. 15% of 3 billion is 450 million barrels. Today, oil in the ground in Guyana is estimated to worth anything between $6 to $8. Let's just give it a $5 mark. 400 million barrels times $5, it's $2 billion. So again, these are big enough numbers that we feel very comfortable and very happy with 15%.
Just before we move on, as far as the plans for next year, the drilling program, you'll have that nailed down by the end of the year?
We will know by the end of the year, yes. Again, Tullow is the operator, they call the shots, right. We'll participate in the meeting. I think we will know better, or we will hear some more defined plan from Tullow in their capital markets day, which is due on the 29th of November this year. So in a month from now, we will know much better.
Just a quick word, Gil, on Namibia. You're looking for a new partner there for the Cooper block?
Tullow was our partner on the Cooper block. Tullow decided to focus and to shift their majority of their exploration budget into Guyana. Mm. And I can perfectly understand it. We partner on both sides of the Atlantic, so we understand their reasons. Bear in mind they have a 60% working interest in Guyana, so their check will for every well will be a bit bigger than ours, or four times bigger than ours. So I can perfectly understand their decision. Tullow did not leave Namibia. They still operate and own the block which is adjacent to ours, but based on their decision to focus their exploration budget next year in Guyana, they came to a conclusion that it will be the best for them as well as for us to leave the Cooper block at the moment, and they simply retransfer to us their entire working interest. So we end up with 57.5% working interest on Cooper block in Namibia, but we already been fully carried on the entire 3D seismic survey, the interpretation. So we are drill ready. Mm. We got the drilling permits a month ago. So I believe that with our 57.5%, with Azinam as a very good partner, with 32.5%, and with NAMCO, the National Petroleum Corporation of Namibia, we will be able to bring in the next big partner to come and drill it for us, hopefully in the next year or so. We have 2.5 years, or almost 3 years ahead of us, but I believe that Namibia still being very attractive for explorers, with the recent entry of Exxon, with the recent entry of Total, with the drilling plans by Shell, Total and Exxon for next year, I believe it will be very reasonable to assume that we will be able to farm down a piece of our 57.5% for the next big partner to come and drill it for us.
A lot to look forward to. Gil, thanks very much.
Thank you very much, Andrew.